Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Salam sehat. Hello Indonesia. My name is Rindy Alpianasari. I am sophomore student of the Diploma through Pharmacy Study program at the Health Polytechnic of the Ministry of Health Gorontalo. I am the representative of the Health Polytech of the Ministry of Health of Gorontalo in the selection of mahasiswa berprestasi Poltekkes Kemenkes 2021. My hobby are dancing, reading, and also editing animate video. My pleasure in editing animate video led me to become the one winner of the YouTube and TikTok video in the commemoration of World Food Day, which was held by BPOM in Jakarta. These are some of my achievements while in the Diploma through Pharmacy Study program at the Ministry of Health Gorontalo Polytechnic. First, as the winner of the poster competition on the anniversary of the Diploma through Pharmacy Study program in 2021. Then, as the third winner of the creative video competition at the 2021 Diploma through Pharmacy Disnatalis Study program. And also, as the first winner of the creative video competition commemoration of the National World Food Day in 2021. I personally like pharmacy, especially in the field of immunology and pharmacology, and the process of how drugs can have an effect on humans in treating diseases. I am also interested in research, because by doing research we can be useful and can be changed in the field of science that we are involved in. Especially pharmacy in the future for better achievements in the health sector for everyone. As we know that the emergence of the coronavirus outbreak at the end of 2019 has had a huge impact on people's life around the world, especially in the health sector. This happens because the number of cases and deaths continues to increase from time to time. Based on World Health Organization data on July 4, 2021, the number of confirmed cases reached more than 1,084 million, with the death toll reaching 4 million people worldwide. Several steps that have been taken to break the chains of this virus, including wearing masks, washing hands, maintaining distance, and increasing immunity, do not seem to have full success in breaking the chains of spreading this virus. Vaccine development is a strategy taken by scientists to stop this pandemic in the hope that a vaccine will be formed that effectively protects and creates immunity in individual and creates herd immunity. A prospective pharmacist, I am also interested in taking part in this effort, namely the effort to design an effective vaccine to break the chains of spread of the SARS-CoV-2 virus. Are you familiar with bioinformatics? Yes, bioinformatics is one approach that can be taken to design drug including vaccine through computerized simulation. This method is often used in drug development because it can minimize the use of excessive experimental animals and can produce a vaccine or drug candidate that is effective and safe. Some literature say that this method has been widely used and has succeeded in producing various types of drug and vaccine candidate. My product is a COVID-19 vaccine designed from the SARS-CoV-2 spike protein that use a bioinformatic approach. The vaccine design that a product is expected to be one of the answer to the current pandemic problem. The spike protein is one of the most important proteins in the body of SARS-CoV-2 and has become the most targeted protein in drug and vaccine development. Therefore, in this product, I use spike protein as a base material for developing a COVID-19 vaccine. In designing this type of vaccine, the first thing I did was take the spike protein from the National Center for Biotechnology Information or protein database in the form of an amino acid sequence. Then I put it in three types of software engines. The first is to predict the majority compatibility complex class 1 epitope. The second is majority compatibility complex class 2, and the third is B cell. After that, the epitopes that had been obtained were tested for antigenicity, allergenicity, and toxicity. Then we used the epitopes with the best characteristic as vaccine base material with some additional ingredients such as adjuvant, padre sequence, and linker. Then I characterize them and make them in 3 dimension. At the end, I did pharmacologic testing using molecular docking, and I am proud to present the result of the vaccine that I have successfully designed. It can be seen that the vaccine has 355 amino acids, a molecular weight of 37.578 kis hydrophilic, and has an acidic pH. This is centrally important in increasing the effectiveness of the vaccine to create individual immunity. Furthermore, based on pharmacological tests using molecular docking, satisfactory interaction results were obtained between the vaccine and its target protein, namely ACA2 and TLR8. The strong interaction between the vaccine protein and the target protein allows the activation of immune system cell in the human body to differentiate and produce cell T and B cell memory, as well as the production of antibodies that are important for individual immunity. The results of this product are expected to be a stepping stone in the development of an effective vaccine in stopping this pandemic. The result of the vaccine that we produce can be recombined in the laboratory and further testing in vitro, in vivo, and clinical relates to its effectiveness as COVID-19 vaccine. Finally, I hope this research can contribute to increased immune system through the pandemic menuju Indonesia sehat.